हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सरांशी सरकाईश मित्तल एंड टुडे आई एम हियर विद द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ वीडियो गेस्ट पोस्ट। बेसिकली अंडर दिस कॉन्सेप्ट रीडर विल बी इनवाइटेड एंड दे विल कम अप विद देयर ऑन टॉपिक रिगार्डिंग टू लिटरेरी कम्युनिटी और रिलेटेबल कम्युनिटी, फॉर एग्जांपल पब्लिशिंग कम्युनिटी, रीडिंग कम्युनिटी, राइटिंग कम्युनिटी और एनी रिलेटेबल कम्युनिटी। दे विल कम अप विद देयर ऑन रिसर्च और एक्सपीरियंस, सो their opinion are not influenced by me at all. So without wasting much time, let's see who is the guest in my channel today.
Well, for instance, consider the situation where I give you two words, writer and an author. Now I ask you to clearly make out the difference between these two words. Well, I guess you are having a doubt within yourself. Then don't worry, it's absolutely fine, because I too was in the same situation where I used to think that both the words writer and author are almost same, because they have been used interchangeably among the articles, blogs, books and many more. But actually, these two words are quite a different ones, which we are aware, sometimes are not aware. You are enough intelligent to understand why I am here and what I am going to speak. So today in this video, we'll be discussing about what is the difference between a writer and an author. But for the delay, let's dive into the video. Hello everyone, this is Achyut Murari. I am a medico second year MBBS from Usmania Medical College, Hyderabad, and an Instagram poet, and I run a booktube channel under the name Among the Pages. Well, I really thank Isha, that is Saransh, author, for having me on board to be able to sharing my opinions and my research upon her channel. So without further delay, let's get started. When we are discussing about the differences, I need to be dividing this video again into two sections. The first section is speaking about technicality, and the second section goes into what is actually my opinion. Now when we go to the technical section, we will be discussing about the definitions which have been provided accurately by many people around the world. Now, as they speak about writer, they simply say that writer is actually the one who actually writes. That's it. As simple as that. A person who writes whatever he or she feels onto a book or a piece of paper, maybe on a blog, maybe on an article. Writing can be interconvertibly changed into both academic writing or into literature writing. Some say creative writing, and some go with the writing of the blogs, articles and many more. They can be content creators, they can be content writers, there can be ghost writers, and there can be pseudo writers too. Well, all of these clearly sends out the message that a writer is basically a person who inks all his or her muses or thoughts or facts directly onto a piece of paper or a blank space. And if at all we are dropping into the idea of author, an author somewhere is a person who is actually published, and that is what the standard definitions about author say. An author is indeed a writer who has got his or her works published over a publishing platform and is actually being selling his copies or books into the markets. And that is what an author called. So even if you are a poet, even if you are a writer, if at all you are actually being published and are able to sell your own content through books, that is paperbacks or ebooks, to the people around, you will be considered an author or will be added to the author's community. This is actually the technical section of the video. But there has been again a huge difference in the understandings of both the writers and authors, according to my opinion, which I'll be speaking now. While they say that an author who inks all his thoughts into a book actually speaks through his book. When we actually open a book and start reading about a particular story, autobiography, fiction, non-fiction, historical fiction, many more, we clearly are into a situation where the author directly speaks to us on a one-to-one manner. He or she writes down all their musings, all their thoughts, adds metaphors, personifications, and many literary terms and literary ways to convince us to be reading and flipping the pages forward, so that we are into a new world created by the author in the book, may it be fiction or non-fiction. The author himself or herself edits the stuff and tries to publish it clearly, makes a draft, gets a script, adds chapters, adds text, context, even adds some of the trivia, maps, and many more. And that is what an author is actually called about. Do you know that the author actually is called as a scripter by Barthes, who is one of the greatest essayists? In his essay called The Death of an Author, published way back in 1967, Barthes argues that an author basically needs to be called as a scripter, because he actually edits his script, writes it, and eventually comes up with a new context which can be easily added into that script. There are stunning lines, stunning story present subtly between those lines, which are clearly shared by the author with that of the readers. And of course, every author creates a wonder within the book. Even if the book is so thick or so thin, there is a new world which is clearly being installed into that book, and we are entering into that world while we are reading, and we as the readers need to be understanding the difference between the authors and the writers. as we clearly discuss about the authors and writers, we also need to understand the difference between the academics and as well as the literature. Using simply the term called book will not be sufficient. If we speak about the word book, we need to be clearly making out the fact both about academics as well as literature. In this world full of studies and academics, the authors are basically the persons who write their research articles, their understanding of the topic into thick books and try to publish that. They are called the academic authors. There are no academic writers at all because a writer completely depends upon his own creativity. But academics is not supposed to be based on creativity. It is supposed to be based on facts, proven facts and scientific discussions and scientific proofs. Hence, all the authors, of course, whenever into the genre of academics, they are the authors. But while you jump into the section of literature, it kind of changes a bit. In literature, there are writers and authors. Writers simply write whatever comes into their mind. It is kind of really crude. But an author is completely a refined way of presenting the books. May be written in their own regional language, may be written in English or any other translated language. It clearly sends out the message that an author is a person who speaks to the reader when he or she opens the books. Authors need to be a good storyteller too, especially into the genre of fiction. Hence, for the readers of the fiction or the lovers of fiction, the term called the author plays a very crucial role, and he is actually a multifaceted person who is able to clearly tell out the story very beautifully, very enticingly, and actually grab the attention of all the readers. So may it be a fiction, may it be a non-fiction, I hope you as a reader would have now understood the difference between a writer and an author in the terms of academics as well as literature. I hope I could be of any help to you in understanding the difference between those two terms. And yet again, I thank Isha for having me in here. Well, till the next video, take care. Bye-bye.
Thank you so much to share your opinion, research and experience on this topic. You can follow this reader on their respective social media platform or contact through email. Let me know in the comment section what's your perspective on this topic, and don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. I will come up with new bookish content soon. Till then, keep reading and start imagining.